This is a great question by Eric Janse last night after another technically challenging YouTube live event. He says, Dr. Brewer, I noticed a very strange phenomenon. That is, a number of people with diabetes type 2 is increasing over the years. However, the number of heart attacks and heart events in general are generally decreasing over the years. You would expect with an increasing number of diabetes, too, also the number of heart attacks will increase. Do you have an explanation for this phenomenon? Yeah, there's a lot of people that have noticed this, and a lot of people have explanations. Before I get to the bottom line, though, I just want to raise a couple of issues. First of all, insulin resistance causes plaque and inflammation, and therefore heart attack and stroke, as well as type 2 diabetes. What? Dozens of people with type 2 diabetes that have not been diagnosed. I mean, you see that in our channel all the time. People saying, like OAG wrote in and said, you know, I did that OGTT and I have full-blown diabetes. My doctor never even noticed it. It's because doctors are not diagnosing diabetes properly. That's a tiny tip of the iceberg, however. There are dozens and hundreds of people with IR, diagnosed IR, insulin resistance, or prediabetes for every type 2 diabetes patient. And then think about it and multiply that by 10 all over again, because it's really clear that there's at least 10. I mean, the CDC, as conservative as they are, says there's at least 10 for every people with undiagnosed insulin resistance for every person that has diagnosed insulin resistance. Now let's go back and talk about physiology. As long as you've got insulin resistance and your blood sugar is going up and staying 140, 180 and higher for hours a day, you're burning your glycocalyx. Therefore, your LDL is slipping through that damaged glycocalyx and lodging in the artery wall. Therefore, you're getting plaque. And your body's attacking it with inflammation. So basically, you've got thousands of people with this plaque development process and inflammation development process for every one diagnosed type 2 diabetic. You could double, triple, and quadruple the number of diagnosed cases just by changing the way we diagnose it and getting a little better at it, and still not increase the number of actual pre-diabetic cases that are out there. Having said all of that, I don't think that's the case, and neither do other people. Most of us think, you know what, we're not really getting that much better at diagnosing insulin resistance or diabetes at this point. Maybe a little better, but the real issue is, let's give the doctors credit. You know, the doctors that you like to beat up and criticize so often, they're really doing a good job. And not just the docs, the patients are as well. For example, look at stroke. Strokes have decreased dramatically. And here's why. Your typical hypertension patient used to run around with blood pressures of 140, 160, 180. I mean, just huge blood pressure problems. And you don't see that as much anymore. We're managing blood pressure better. We're managing pre-event. We're managing the event better. And we're managing post-event. So we don't have as many events happening. When they do happen, we're managing them better. So medicine's getting better. But here's the thing. Let's say we diagnose more diabetics or more late pre-diabetics. I'd still much rather see us move 2 decades earlier and start finding people in their 40s and 30s and 20s where they're starting to develop mild insulin resistance. Notify them. Make sure that they understand it and motivate them on how to change it. Thank you for your interest. If plaque is the number one cause of heart attack, stroke, dementia, blindness, kidney disease, you'd think we'd know how to evaluate it, screen for it, wouldn't you? Unfortunately, the state of the art right now is a guess, and a bad one at that, Framingham. The most common thing that you do is you say, well, hey, doc, why don't we do a stress test? They don't work either. Then you go into the cath lab and get a definitive test, but that involves getting a needle in the groin. It just goes downhill from there. Now, there are better ways. Take a look at our plaque evaluation course. Click the link below.